Hey, what's up, dudes? Kublai Khan here. Welcome back to Fallout 4 Survival Roleplay with our Sugar Bomb Commando build, and we are looking at a melon. I realize that you can go ahead and zoom in on a lot of these 3D renderings of things, and this is the melon. This is looks a little different than the normal melons that we're used to, but I imagine that without having the kind of husbandry to make... Oh, God! Is husbandry even the right thing to say? You're okay, dog. Follow me.
Moving out.
You can attack. If he's nearby, attack him. Good boy. That's actually pretty sick. We could just send him off. But yeah, is husbandry the right thing to say for, like, growing food in certain ways? There you are. Yes. Blow him up. Ooh, there's our first submachine gun. All right, dog, here. We need to probably back off a little bit. Things have getting a little crazy. And if we back off a little bit, we can, like, go back to some of the saves. We can kind of look around at some of the items. You coming, boy? Yeah, there you go. Let's do that. I mean, check it. They have aluminum cans. All right. Okay, well, people are shooting at us again. Let's hold on to that submachine gun. There might be some things we can do with that in the future. I mean, if whatever upgrades we put on it, for example, will eventually be upgrades that we put on all our other cool submachine guns that we're going to pick up. Where's the dog? God, that dog just loves running off and getting into, like, the middle of fights. I mean, I'm kind of proud of it in a way for doing it, but there you are. But it's also stupid. I wonder if the dog feels bad that I keep eating mutt chops in front of it. Just pretty consistently. I'm just, like, munching on them in the middle of this fight. Which is teaching me more and more about the advantages of being able to have higher endurance and being able to run in with a little bit extra damage protection. You know, it's actually been pretty quiet up here for a little bit. Hello? 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 Did most of them come charging after us? Yeah, I'm jamming the VATS button, not really finding anyone. It seems like I'm just gonna go ahead and grab that bobblehead. Oh, there it is. Ooh, a shotgun, good sir. There we go, got you. Switching back to the a little better. Woo! God, they're cutting right into us. And this is what we came up here for.
Perfect.
Repair bobblehead. Now, one of the things that is a bit of a problematic with the repair bobblehead is we're basically not gonna use the damn thing. I mean, like, I will use it for when we're wearing some power armor, but power armor is not a normal thing. Whew. I am so impressed with this game sometimes. I mean, what's really cool is that if there are people walking along there, if you zoom in, you'll actually get to see them. And I have my, like, draw distance pretty low, too, compared in, like, actor fade pretty low. So it is very pretty and impressive to see. That looks like jungle gym equipment down there. You know, do you guys know where there's, like, a commando perk bobblehead? I would like to see something like a rifleman style thing. I'm really curious where that would be. I'm assuming somewhere in the gunners. I think, I'm trying to decide what way I want to go in. I think this is actually a pretty good way to go in. We might want to actually just... Yeah, we're going to just save over there. I mean, even going through the front door is nice. Because this is a kind of game where it's like, we're not a stealth character. We're about killing as many people as possible. And I mean, most of our characters we've ever played has always been about killing as many people as possible. But it's just getting those kills really provide a nice experience boost, too. So it's like, why not? You know, I've never gotten the railway rifle. I'm not exactly sure how one picks it up. And we have a little random railway rifle moment because we had a little crash. It happens sometimes, but the thing is, it was so recent to when we dropped a save that really it was just about a couple minutes of me going like, oh, the game crashed. Which is problematic, definitely so. But gameplay-wise and filming-wise, no problem whatsoever. So I guess we'll just go straight through the front. I know we can do the little secret way, but I like the front. They have a monkey. I mean, the thing that would only be more exciting than the monkey would be if it was a little penguin that goes wah, 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 rather than the little symbols thing. Also, if you notice, I all of a sudden seem brighter. I realized that my color was a little off in my camera, so I fixed that.
Hey, I think someone's out there.
You don't know what you hear. And ready with the grenade? I love the way the lighting looks as you enter this spot. I mean, this is clearly, they designed this whole, like... The way that the two lights go there, the double shadow, it actually forms the jack-o'-lantern on the ground with the paper eyes right there. I think it just looks so cool. Now, dog, please do not hit the tripwire. There we go. Pick up some fans. Typewriters suck to hold, but I grabbed one accidentally. All right, before we just sort of initiate hell, which I just kind of did. Seems like they heard me. I was gonna say before I initiate hell, I wanted to just sneak around a little bit just to make sure I got everything. Stirred up over nothing. I feel like hearing a bunch of rounds fire and then a friend die would be an indicator. I'm gonna try to sneak as close in as I can. I know our character isn't really a sneak character, but a good way to kind of encourage that, you know, keeping that behavior from happening is by keeping perks out of the certain things, because then it really makes it like nigh impossible to work. Let's throw another grenade in there. Someone's gonna be coming soon. Nobody came. It's like nobody cared about you, bud. Sorry about that. The jet'll make you jittery. Yeah, fragmentation grenades just have a sound that sounds so similar to jet, don't they? Jesus Christ, I'm still able to sneak through this? I have not been silent. You guys see the thing where the person's been using the mines in the basket? Hold on, let's try that. Hopefully I don't kill myself doing this, but I've really wanted to try it ever since I saw it on the TV. We gotta find a better way to rotate. There you go. All right, so the way that this is supposed to work is that the person walks up and hits the mine that is being carried. Yes, it sounds stupid. Apparently it's surprisingly effective. A lot of people dead here. That grenade did a good job. All right, we're gonna put that there right now. Pick up what's in here.
Get a grip. It's getting worse. Another recruit. What the fuck was that?
Oh, perfect. Trash can bomb time. Trash can bomb time. Trash can bomb time. Trash can bomb time. It's stuck. It's stuck. Oh god, trash can bomb is just gonna explode normally. Did my dog take a mine to the fucking face? Well, there's a lot of light bulbs, which are actually really good for certain items. I forget what specifically, but they're kind of a rare thing. Where did the other one go? God, I loved this body that just hit the wall and dropped. All right, we're in danger, but a lot of the people who we were probably in danger by were dead. That one's still alive, but seems to not really care too much about us. Bitch go. How do you guys even know I'm a woman? I'm kind of curious about that. At what point did you guys catch a glimpse of me and leave? There you go, you did. But now you're just dead. Gotta go to the one over here. Whoa, there's a bunch of them. Woo. Not bad. Working out pretty well. Oh, ayo. And so I do the little better. I think the little better might actually not be as better. Better little, fuck, what am I trying to say? Might not actually be a little better. It might be a little worse. All right, we're gonna try to get that one with a grenade. Well, the dog's going for it. Demolition's already ready to go to 2. Ah, hell, demolition up to 2. Reusing them. I wouldn't mind a bigger spread. Oh great, my dog's dying. I hope he doesn't take the fact that I'm eating mutt chops as a negative sign. So wait, you were running at me with a pipe? Like I get, like, I'm very proud of your, like, creativity and drive, not your creativity, but definitely your drive. Are you guys gonna crawl out of the woodwork now? No? Okay, well, I'll just wait. Anyway, I'm very proud of your drive, but your creativity is sorely lacking. Can you, oh, I hear the scary dudes coming out now. I don't feel like they have armor, so I'm gonna switch back to this. All right. There you are. Hey-o. Well, we got a lot of ammunition for this now. Woo-wee. Rockin' hydrated, tons of ammo. Kitchen scale, couldn't be happier. I'm actually gonna pop through this direction because I do believe there are beds in this way. Well, down there are ghouls, so I don't wanna go quite down that way. And there will be beds in the next room, but I don't wanna go from this direction. This is actually kind of a tough direction to do the attack from. I much prefer this direction because people kinda get bottlenecked through here, which is really nice. There we go. Not too much of a problem. Shut the fuck up for a second. I hear something. That guy just died. Clearly, something maybe possibly up. Come out and fight. There you are. Gotcha. Oh, hey. All right, gotcha too. Now we just have the machine gun turret, which I'm gonna be smart about because this has actually killed me a few. We get the arc now. But I totally missed that. So let's just, there we go. I should be able to open this now. Yeah, because of that one key that we picked up a while back. Now I just kind of want the ammunition, I think. Back into hidden. And another submachine gun. Definitely don't need to carry two of those. They're pretty heavy, and I only need the ammunition out of it. Is this the way that we're? Yeah, we were just on the other side of this. Huh? Oh, this is where there's a perpetual motion pod. It's not happening right now, but it did happen with Fizzy. This kind of looks like a T-Rex face. Like there's his eye, there's his mouth, or like top of the mouth, the nose, and the bottom mouth. That totally does look like a dinosaur face to me. Rawr. Alright, so we've messed around with a lot of the guys so far, and they seem to still not know where we are. Which is weird, because our character is not a sneaky character. But we have more or less surprised everyone consistently. I mean, we'll just continue, I guess. We'll get to the edge, hop up on this, look down, to rain fire upon them. There we go. Where even are you? Seriously, I'm
payback time,
there you are. For you guys. That hurt a lot. Ooh, look, we picked up some razor grain, which will be really useful when we finally get to do some noodle cups. You know, unfortunately, it looks like we've actually lost a lot of our food that we would use to be healing. That was a weird bark. Oh, you're just burning to death. You're gonna die now. Hidden away. All right, that'll be perfect. We can even sleep. I love how we just throw one single Molotov down, burns everyone away. And I mean, we have very high like power now in the case of Molotovs, but still, it feels really well done. You know, I remember talking about how I felt like these guys might be so angry because they're sleeping on straw pillows. I mean, I don't know how soft straw is. It might be actually not that bad. I've always had like those fluffy like cottony pillow stuff where they just like, it doesn't have actual feathers in it, it's just the goop. I felt like those did pretty well. Anyway, a lot of coolant caps and I wonder if gear is technically a gear, if that's like actually gears or if it's just like metal. It's steel. Stupid. That's ridiculous. It should be something better than that. Should be like a gear, you know. All right then, well, Corvega Plant has been so far, like we've almost died a lot during the process because of just our life getting knocked down. But because there's just enough like food and things around, we've been able to heal up. And it is true that I'm a little low on like food right now, but I have tons of stim packs. So I'm able to survive. You know, a note that I forgot about. So a couple episodes ago, I used a robot to help me out clearing the shipping area. I can't recall if I actually then killed the robot. I don't think I was able to find it, which is why it wasn't in my head. But we're about to go up against a bunch of dudes, and having a robot help is actually very useful. So the plan here will be to get the robot going. If the robot lives, we kill it, because you gotta explode, and that's kind of part of the character. All right, let's activate that unit. Perfect.
Powering up.
All right, you go ahead and start fighting, wonderful unit. We're just gonna hang out here, dog and I.
Intruder.
Hold.
Stay. Perfect. Hang out here, let the robot do the fighting. There's a lot of cars in here, which are gonna cause some pretty cool explosions too, which I feel like, now that I've said that out loud, probably should be part of how the character plays. Blowing up cars. Like, that makes sense. They like explosions. The problem is that it takes, like, ammunition to do it. But, I think that could... It's probably the happiest day of our character's life. You survived that. Ooh, another one. That was wonderful. Oh! Are they going in a line? Oh, we're just gonna hang out here until that all happens then. A machine gun turret's still okay. And a raider scum. It's the only two people that I see. Hello! Wait. A little better. All right. Anybody else? No, I think that's everybody. Perfect. And we had all the big explosions too. That was a lot of fun. Oh, oh god. Oh god. Get across. There we go. Ow, god. Wow, that punch really took a lot of life. I think I'm actually gonna have some grilled rad stack, because that's gonna heal us up and allow us to carry more stuff. There we go. Two birds, one stone. Plop the quick save too. Alright, we'll have another Grognak Barbarian here, which is another thing that we're not really needing to use. And apparently we're being attacked again by new people. You know, I feel like the good enough is actually doing better. He's going after the dog, isn't he? Yep. I left the dog towards the front, and that's where they came out and attacked. You know what, dog? You can do some amazing things. Sometimes, though... God, man. Hey, perpetual motion bot! Yay. I don't know whose head this is, but that's exactly what I'm grabbing all this stuff from. So I haven't found Jared yet. He's gonna be here somewhere. Oh, there he is. Corvega safe key, stim pack, drifter out. Ooh, I don't want the drifter outfit. All right, so where is the Corvega safe? Because I always get this safe key, but it's, I don't just know where the safe is. Well, the dog's kicking all the stuff around. Yeah, I just don't know where the damn thing is. All right, well, Corvega's done. But anyway, on to the worst part of survival mode's design, which is probably just they didn't think about this, and maybe it makes more sense when if you join the Minutemen, you can turn in things through the Minuteman radio. But I have to go back to the people at Ten Pines Bluff, then I go back to Preston Garvey. I have to do that to turn in the Corvega Plant thing, the entire part. It's just kind of ridiculous that so many things have to be done for me to just turn in this single quest. Now, to kind of fix this a little bit, I'll be able to go and move Preston Garvey to live with the dog, the junkyard dog, down in the Starlight Drive-In. But that's really not the best fix. So, I mean, our character will totally do some of those missions, like, related to it, and potentially that will work, but I don't know. Is kind of a bummer to have to just walk all the way back. Also, I think after this, might make sense to go to Professor Goodfield's, pick up that new magazine that's down there, because I think that would, after I made my comment about the food and everything, I'm run out, so I think it makes sense to go ahead and try to get it. There's a glowing rad roach. Hold on, we have a new toy to try. Let's try this puppy out. Oh, god! I jumped right over me. Wasn't really ready for that. These guns are definitely, like, you need a good distance from them because the way that the kick hits you, it's you kind of just need to either keep it at waist level or you need to just aim down. Alright then, well, let's go to the box that always seems to magically have Rad X in it. Rad away today. Ooh, hello. Play with the new gun some more. And we're falling down health-wise pretty quickly. Alright, so this has been fun to use, but it's definitely not our most powerful weapon. Which makes its weight to, like, damage ratio pretty shitty. I might actually want to just hold on to the ammunition that we do have for it. Because we're going to be wanting to use it when we get the better gun. Alright, now we have the... Oh, that's Glitch Canyon, or whatever canyon it is. It's got a couple books, and it has a new tattoo, which we might want to do. Heyo. What was I looking at? I was looking at... Concord in that spot right beneath it. Oh, this is the canyon. This is where you fight the Mirelurks. Ooh, this is interesting too, because we're gonna have to pop a big Radex if we were gonna do this one. I'm gonna find that book or the tattoo real quick, and then I think I'm just gonna keep moving on. Tattoo. New unique facial tattoo. Also, the reason why I'm trying to just get to the Ten Pines Bluff people is because all of a sudden they're going to go, oh my gosh, I'm so excited. We can work with you and the Minutemen. And then I'm going to be able to take advantage of that moment and say, all right, you guys are now going to be provisioners and walk back and forth between this location and Sanctuary. And I'm going to send the other person to... Ooh, Noodle Cup, nice. Oh, I should have held on to that because then I could have... Then I could have planted ramen, whatever it's called. Anyway, point being that we could send them back and forth, and then we'll be able to drop all our stuff into Ten Pines. So I'm spending a lot more focus on the settlement portion right now. I don't know if it necessarily makes the most sense. We didn't really need to do it with Fizzy. And I doubt we really need to do it with our V character right now, but it's just like, I think it'll be interesting to kind of try to set this up a little bit differently. And my, one of my main things is because of the radiation, right? Like, you might not think that matters as much, but something as small like that just cutting into my health makes me want to focus more on guns and, you know, making sure that the guns are good. Especially because if we're going to be evil, we're going to have to take some other bad situations for our character. And I mean, we can't be total evil because of how the game works. Get that, Nuka! But I mean, it's evil enough. It's still going to have an effect. Alright, here we are. Let's chat with these lovely people. Set up some provisioners. I need to be a certain local leader to do that, don't I? Oh crap, never mind. That's okay. Take your time. I'm not on the clock here or anything. Not at all.
Find those raiders?
Kick their asses.
Yeah, I kicked their asses for you.
No kidding? That's the best piece of...
Right.
So we've been talking.
Right.
We just...
Yeah, you're in. Cool. So that way I can kill you all with the raider moments. So I need to have charisma 6 to do local leader and ascend the provisioners. I do have another idea, though, which would work okay. Give her all the junk, as much as she can carry. I can't move you from this settlement? What about you? That's different than a supply line. Oh, man. Never mind. Well, that was the plan. It was to move them straight away to the other settlement so that I could just
don't
meet them there.
I just... I just want to trade a few things.
I don't know why she's so kind of hesitant about talking. I think it's an interesting thing about the character because that just seems so out of place for who she is. And that was somewhat disappointing. I mean, at least we were able to get the experience for it. But I mean, I expected more. You know, I expected the ability to send people, but I realized that needs to be Charisma 6, which is now seeming to be an extremely more useful perk if I actually want to do the settlement thing. And then even more so on all of that, we have to think about how some people aren't willing to leave to go around. Like, I like the idea of being able to send people around because then it's send one person one way, send another person another way, and that works pretty well in the process of moving items. All right, well, at least we'll be able to send Garvey down to Starlight Drive-In. And then we'll just keep moving him around so that we can just turn in quests to him. I mean, until we all of a sudden become going to the castle or something like that. If we even do that, I don't even know if that's going to really happen with her character. That's just far enough down the Miniman quest line that it might not. So I live in a city. Stars do not ever look like this. I've only once seen stars like this when I was in middle school. I was like probably 11. You know, because I'm used to seeing like a couple stars, but something like this is mind-boggling to me. And I really think it would be cool if they had like a hole in the moon, which is a ridiculous ask. But like, some shooting stars every once in a while, rather than just the speckles. Rad stag dough. Perfect. Gotta get some of that. Ooh, wild mud fruit. That's really useful. I don't know what the thistle's good for, but I grabbed it. Alright, for some reason the wild mud fruit isn't allowing me to plant it, but there we go. We'll plant this current mud fruit plant, and that will work just fine. Then we're gonna pick some corn. And plant the next corn. Slowly growing up our stocks, eh? Oh, except we actually had picked up another corn from somewhere.
You know that settlement you sent me to help? They've decided to join the Minutemen.
Yeah!
That's great news.
Alright, Preston, we can move to the Starlight Drive-In. That's
hey.
Where you're headed.
Is something you need?
Yes, let's give you that flare gun you handed
need,
me.
General.
Hello, Carla. You're always showing up at the best of times. Leaving him the teddy bear. Let's see what we can do with the submachine gun. Armor piercing receiver, hardened receiver. It's actually, at 17, that's cool. But we're at doing 18 or 17 are, like, good enough and the like. So I actually don't think that makes sense. I mean, maybe it fires faster, but I haven't really felt like that was the case. I think, for now, we're just gonna scrap the thing. I mean, in a way, it's just like, eh, why not? Plus, we're gonna be able to find that better one eventually, too. And we're just saving the ammunition until then. I think our next thing we're going to do is we're going to just head in this direction, find Mr. Goodfields, and then pop down this one. We might kill everybody at Grey Garden. Not because I necessarily want to in any way, I guess, but because it's like we blow up robots and we haven't had a lot of robots to blow up. So I don't really see why we wouldn't try to blow them up as our character. It's not that I've talked about how we're like, we're not like bad 100% or that kind of thing. But we definitely have kind of that dark side about us that I think should be shared. So, I mean, it's kind of like we go out of our... It almost could be like how the ghoul was, where he, like, would go out of his way only to kill ferals, where maybe we'll only go out of our way to kill, like, not fun robots. But we've already avoided the Mr. Gutsy that was super powerful because it was going to kill us. So, by doing that, that kind of makes me feel like our character is intelligent about it. And if they're intelligent about it, are you fighting a bloatfly? If they're being intelligent about it, I feel like I could imagine us trying to go after those guys too. But if they're too high a level, I could also understand not wasting up our ammunition to do it. It's kind of something I'm not 100% sure about. God, I hate blood bugs. And, alright, I don't know if the rads are going to be worth going into here. There's stuff there. No, let's not do it. I'm gonna be smart about this. Let's stay back. Keep getting those extra 10 rads just running through the water, though. Oh, this is the sad cabin. What? Oh, more rad stacks. And blowflies. Woo! You know, that fires 3 shots when only 1 was needed. Oh, hey-o. Yeah, this is sad cabin. Ooh, and that was a level up. Totally worth doing. All perpetual motion head. Doing its thing. Oh, don't stop. Anyway, I think I'm going to drop a save at sad cabin. And let's listen to the runaway holotape. Because it's actually really quite cool. Let's grab that laundered green dress. It might be nicer than the one I'm currently having. Green is worth a little more. Let's see. Green's nice. I like it. I think I prefer the green. I think I actually do prefer the green. So this is a bit of a sad one. I really like it.
October 22nd, 2077.
This is right before the bombs explode.
I finally told them tonight. And it was bad. Real bad. Dad was shouting. Telling me I should be ashamed, that I had to get out of the house. Mom just cried, and somehow that hurt worse than anything else. She didn't say a word, not even when I packed my things. I can't go to John. He doesn't even know yet. Maybe he'll never know. If it weren't for the cabin, I wouldn't have a place to sleep. Just need some time to think. Last time I was here, I was just a little girl playing clubhouse in this old cabin. Now I'm really scared. Will anything ever be right again?
So I really like that one. It's, it just feels very... Like, when we were playing Fallout 4, and this is, you know, something that you kind of run into, it was like... It is very fantastic, and I mean that from the point of view of, like, of a world that it builds. The world is fantastic, and it's the kind of it's fantastic realism is actually the best term used for it, which basically means that what happens here is based in reality, but it's not quite there. You know, like, there's enough differences and weirdness that make it something of its own. There's our place that we're headed to, and I think I'll, hold on, let's get this mission real quick. I've been told this is actually a really cool mission, and you guys recommend me do it. Also, let's get that other level up. Alright, something opens up at level 11, Commando 2. Well, there's our first legendary opportunity. So, but let's keep talking about the, situation with this girl. So, it's fantastic realism, as in, like, bloatflies would probably never exist. Shit, that was very, very poorly thrown. Ooh. That was a lot of damage like that. We're doing okay. Where'd the bloatfly... Oh my god. We're about to die. But more so than that, where is the bloatfly? That was a legendary creature, and where is this? Holy crap! Pow! powerful switchblade, 25% more damage. That's certainly cool, but not exactly what it was. Oh, a lot of radiation. A lot of radiation. I gotta be careful around here, because before the, like, a rad scorpion. That was not a rad scorpion, but a rad scorpion did pop up around here before. But anyway, fantastic realism. The idea that this character, this world, built on reality, but really can't exist. You really couldn't have, like, a death claw kind of thing. You couldn't have a character who has 20% more damage with commando perk, who has, you know, like, action boy, or some of these abilities are just actual magic, you know? So, the thought process is that when you have something along the lines of that girl, it sounds like she's pregnant, and it sounds like, you know, her family got angry, John doesn't know, and then she goes to that cabin, the bomb detonates, kills her and her unborn child. And it's this level of, like, down to earth, something that could really happen. You know, like, the bombs going off, when you watch the intro to this game, I still get goosebumps watching it, because that feels very real. The idea of suddenly, it's a normal day, and then the alarms go off. So, anyway, dudes, we've hit the Sunshine Tidings co-op. We're gonna start cooking, cleaning up some of these places, and I'm gonna drop a save real quick in this cabin here. Maybe not this cabin. Here we go. This is the right cabin. All right then, dudes. So the fantastic realism, and that I was trying to kind of get to, was this idea that Fallout 4 is fake. It's very fake. And certain scenes, like this girl's holotape, where she talks about her family freaking out over the idea that she's pregnant, is such an amazing down-to-earth thing. Because you feel like there would be a family that freaks out like that over their daughter being pregnant. You know, it's like, we hear about it in media and films of, like, this old-fashioned family that when this girl gets pregnant, the reaction is yelling at the girl, like, you're a bad person. It's like this level of treatment of someone, which is ridiculous. It's come from very conservative ideals, and it's sad and it's terrible, which is what I feel like, in a way, makes it feel more real. Like, I think it would be kind of interesting, too, if there was a similar one where, let's say it was, like, more of a liberal family where it's like, yeah, I went to my parents and I told them, and they said, look, like, you could have come to us to, like, help us provide you with some form of contraceptive, and, you know, like, why didn't you go to us? And it's like, oh, I misunderstood. And then, I mean, that would almost be more sad, because then at the end of it, she's like, you know, I talked to my parents and it went well. We're going to talk to John, and we're all going to, you know, it's like, we're going to be safer in the future. We have a bright future ahead of us because technology allows us to be safe and do this. And then all of a sudden, boom, the bomb hits. That would be more sad. Anyway, dudes, thank you so much for watching. It was a total joy to have you here. If you liked what you saw, please leave a like. You want to see more, subscribe. And of course, when the ground rises to each feet, the wind always be at your back, and the sunshine warmly on your sexy, sexy face. Dudes, see you later. Bye.